and welcome today in a very short but very important video. My name is CPA Kulwa Manyana and I am an assistant lecturer from the Open University of Tanzania Faculty of Business Management from the Department of Accounting and Finance. I'm a co-instructor from a course OAF 101, and I'm going to teach you something very small but important. It is called the balancing of the double entry account. So let us take like 10 or less than 10 minutes into looking at this aspect that I'm going to show you how to balance the double entry accounts. Okay, now you'll see I have slides here in between, and I have examples that are going to be used so that if you follow step by step to be able to close or to balance the double entry account. The first step, when you have an account, and then I'm going to be using the T account, as you can see in the slide. One, you have to total the both sides of the account. You have a T account, for example, here you can see we have a furniture account with the debit side and the credit side, and we have transaction from the debit side and the credit side. DR represent the debit and CR represent the credit. So the first step is you are supposed to total the both of the accounts. So total the debit side and the credit side. And if you total the debit side, you're going to get this figure. And then if you total the credit side, you're going to get this figures. And as you can see here, the total of the debit 3,750. Total of the credit is 250, which is less than the amount. So the second step is get the balancing figure by finding the difference between the two steps. Get the balancing figures by finding the difference between the two totals, because now we have the total of the debit side and the total of the credit side. Now you have to get the balancing figures by finding the difference between the two totals. The debit side is 3,750 less the credit side, which is 250. Then you're going to get 3,500. Now this is the balancing figure that we are talking or referring about. Now the balance goes on the lower side of this case, whereby in this case is the credit side. The balance goes on the lower side, whereby in this case is the credit side. Now if you go to the steps three, which is you're supposed to enter the balance on the lower side, just follow this the slide here. You see now the debit side and the credit side. Now the balancing figures goes down, whereby we have the balance carried down of 3,500. I hope you can follow. Now step four, total both sides. Now if you total both sides, you're going to get the 3,750 from the debit side and the credit side, and then the balancing figures there of 3,500 is going to be the balance carried down. Going to the five step, which is you're supposed to bring the balance down below the total of the opposite side. I repeat, bring the balance down below the total of the opposite side. Now these are the procedures. They're very simple, because but now you might take them you might see them very long because you are in the learning process, but when it comes to practice, it's they're very, very simple. So just follow these slides that I'm showing you here. With the same example, our furniture account, the total of the debit side and the total of the credit side. Now here, if you go down here, you see 1st June, the balance brought down. Recall the name here, the balance brought down. Remember, it is coming from the balance carried down, which was on the credit side. Now it is coming on the debit side. That is how you're supposed to bring the balance below to the opposite side. Now the balanced account, it will look like this. You see, this is the balanced account. So you see, it's very simple. That is how you're supposed to balance the accounts. I hope you've understood and you've enjoyed this very, very short video. Now let me add you something new, which is the trial balance. Let me add something new, which is the trial balance. Now, for each of the debit entry, there's corresponding credit entries. Now for each of the debit entry, there is a credit entry. For each of the credit entry, there is also a debit entry. Now if all the items have been recorded properly, we assume that this is what we expect, that in all the accounts, the total of the debit entry should be equal to the total of the credit entries. I repeat, if all the items are going to be recorded in all the accounts properly, then we expect the total of the debit entry should be equal to the total of the credit entry. That means the total of the debit balance should be equal to the total of the trial balance. See the hypothetical example here of the trial balance. We have posted some of the accounts. I'm saying it is hypothetical, whereby the total of the credit entry equals to the total of the debit entry. Now, what do you mean by the trial balance? Well, because I might be saying the name trial balance, and some of us might not be aware of the term trial balance. A trial balance is a balance. A trial balance is a list of balances only. It's a list of balances only that has been arranged according to whether they are debit balances or the credit balances. We balance the accounts, so it has been arranged in that nature, whereby you take into account all the closing amount of the different ledger accounts, and then you post them to come up with the trial balance. You see, I'm giving you examples of different accounts here. We have capital accounts, rent account there, we have equipment account, we have a number of accounts here. Now, the total of the balances here, we're going to take them into a trial balance. And you can see here, this is a trial balance coming up or taking into consideration the total of those accounts that I've been showing you there. You see the total of the debit balance equal to the total of the trial, the total of the credit balance. Okay. Now, since you know the trial balance, sometimes this trial balance might not balance, and then thereby we are saying that we have some errors. Now, these errors, we have two types of errors that might cause or might be observed from the trial balance. Now, one type of errors are errors which results in a trial balance that does not balance. That you have a trial balance that does not balance. And then here, you'll have to click into your mind knowing that, oh, there is an error here. But again, we have errors which do not affect the trial balance. The trial balance seems to be okay. The total of the debit balance equals to the total of the credit balance. But in actual sense, there is an error. Okay? Now, errors which results in a trial balance that does not balance. Let us look at those errors that result in a trial balance that does not balance. One, we have additional errors that we have added incorrectly into these accounts. For example, using one figures for the debit and different figures for the credit, then you add them, then you find out yourself that the totals are not the same. For example, you debit an amount 360 and you credit an amount that is 36, then you leave behind zero. If you add these figures, I'll be sure you're not going to get the same totals equal in the debit side and the credit side. But again, if you're going to enter from one side a transaction that is not required to be entered in that side, entering one side of the transaction only. Okay, another error is arose when you enter one side of the transaction only, for example, or the same 360, for example, has been entered in only one column, in only one part, and not entering in the other part here, not following the double entry system, only entering the debit side and omitting the credit side, be sure that the trial balance will not balance. Okay. Okay, so simply, those are the examples that might cause errors which may deflect the trial balance not to balance. Now, coming to those other errors that actually errors which do not affect the balancing of the trial balance. The trial balance will look perfect that it is balanced, but actually we have errors in it. I'm going to mention them, some of the few, and a bit explaining them. In a nutshell, these errors include errors of omission, errors of commission, errors of principles, original entries, and errors of completed reversal. So these names, don't worry about the names, they're very, very simple. Now, to start with the errors of omissions, both debit and credit entries have been ignored. If you've ignored an entry in both debit and credit entry, then don't expect there would be a change in the trial balance. So as the term itself, omission, we have omitted all the entries, then the trial balance will still balance. And again, errors of commission, correct amount in wrong personal account. You post the correct amount, but in the very, very wrong personal account. Then expect the trial balance to balance, but there is an error in that. Errors of principles, correspond amount in wrong class of account. For example, you posted an expense account into a capital account. Of course, both of them have the same nature, the debit nature. So you expect the trial balance to balance. But actually, in principle, you've posted in a very wrong class of account. Compensating errors, two compensating errors canceling each other. You have an error in one side and another error in the other side. So they compensate, they cancel each other. You won't be able to see them in the trial balance. See, the trial balance won't balance. I mean, since the trial balance was still balanced, then you won't be able to see that error. So we call that compensating errors. Another is the error of original entries. Incorrect amount have been posted from the original time whereby you post that transaction and account. So you keep on going on with that error until you post into the final trial balance. So we call it errors of original entry. Incorrect amount have been posted to correct side of the both sides. You post the same amount in the debit side, and you also have posted the same amount in the credit side. So expect the total of the debit side will be equal to the total of the credit side. The last one is the completely reversal entries. Correct amount to correct accounts, but both entries on incorrect side. You post the correct amount to the correct account, but both entries on the incorrect. But both entries on incorrect side. I repeat, errors of complete reversal, as the name itself said, completely reversal, that you've posted the correct amount to the correct account, but both entries on incorrect side. Thank you very much for watching, and as I've said, it is very simple, small video, but very effective, as it will help you in your journal into accounting to understand some of the concepts that you're going to use them in this course. Thank you.